Why are all the world powers interested in space? Because it is getting harder to live on Earth, some will say. And they won't be wrong. After all, that is exactly what we are asked to believe and exactly what we are shown. But the truth may be different than that, much more earthy and human. Behind it all may be a competition for unseen supremacy and dominance. And the answer may fit in your fist and is very simple. Energy. For many decades now, the world powers have been clear that the cosmos can contain such sources of energy that you can fit enough of it in your handful alone to traverse the universe. But let's abstract away from that scenario and save the energy for another video of ours, because we may actually be facing something much more dangerous and requiring much more urgent measures to save us as a race. Since 1997, more than 150 Mars exploration missions have been made. Even now, if you are fluent in English and between 30 and 55 years old, you could be one of the lucky ones to become an analog astronaut and spend 1 year on Mars. Well, not exactly on the planet Mars, but in a specially created center that mimics the one-to-one environment of Mars. Those selected for the program will have to grow their own food and deal with various staged equipment failures. All of this is intended to put real human beings in real planetary conditions to study how this would affect individuals. In other words, like it or not, the colonization of Mars is in full swing. And at the end of the next decade, we should send the first colonists there to lay the foundations of our new home. Do most of you have any real idea what all this means? Why has the exploration of all countries turned so feverishly towards Mars territory? Is there something we don't know? Is something about to happen that we are not being told about? Did you know that 3 billion years ago Mars was like Earth? A hospitable place for life covered with vast oceans, rivers, and lakes. Evidence of these waterways is found in the planet's deep canyons, dry riverbeds, and polar ice caps. According to scientists, Mars had a thick atmosphere that trapped heat and kept water liquid. It had a strong magnetic field that protected the planet from solar radiation and preserved its atmosphere. But for reasons that are not yet fully understood, this magnetic field has disappeared. Without its protection, the solar wind began to gradually destroy Mars' atmosphere. Giant volcanic eruptions followed. Mount Olympus, the largest volcano in the solar system, probably caused huge changes in the climate of Mars. These volcanic activities have released huge amounts of gases and dust into the atmosphere. Because of this, over time, it became increasingly thin and unable to retain heat. This caused temperatures to drop dramatically, water to freeze, and liquid water to disappear from the surface. The polar ice caps and underground ice deposits are the last remnants of the ancient water age on Mars. If there was life there, it would have probably disappeared or hidden deep beneath the surface, where there may still be water in liquid form. What are the world powers looking for on Mars? Energy, a new home for us, or perhaps both? Is something happening to our planet that is too disturbing to know about? Hypothetically, if we had the technology to rebuild Mars' atmosphere, you'd be amazed at how similar it is to our planet. Through simulation, this process has been visualized, and the result is staggering. And is it possible that Mars looked exactly like this 3 billion years ago? To be completely fair, the idea of sending humans to Mars has been the subject of scientific research since the late 1940s. Proposals include sending settlers and terraforming the planet. Currently, only robotic landers and rovers have landed on Mars. The list of plans for crewed missions to Mars ranges from scientific expeditions in which small groups of between 2 and 8 astronauts would visit the planet for a period of a few weeks or more to a permanent presence such as through research stations, colonization, or other permanent habitation. Meanwhile, unmanned exploration of Mars has been a goal of national space programs for decades and was first realized as early as 1965 with the flyby of Mariner 4. However, there is a window for making an Earth-Mars journey that opens every 26 months. Due to the eccentricity of Mars's orbit, the energy required in the low-energy launch periods varies on a roughly 15-year cycle, with the easiest periods needing only half the energy of the peak periods. The lowest energy transfer to Mars would be a Hohmann transfer orbit, which would be a 9-month trip from Earth to Mars, about 500 days stay on Mars, waiting for the transfer window to Earth, and a 9-month trip back. Actually, to be even more honest and fair, NASA eventually admits what it is looking for on Mars, and even on its official website. There is nothing hidden or covered up.
On Earth, all life forms need water to survive. If life ever evolved on Mars, it probably emerged with long-standing supplies of water. Our search for evidence of life on Mars therefore focuses on areas where there was once stable liquid water, below the surface where it may still exist, or in current hotspots where hydrothermal pools, such as those at Yellowstone, may be habitable. Mars missions are also looking for sources of energy other than sunlight, since life on the surface of Mars is unlikely. On Earth, we find life in many places without sunlight, in the dark ocean depths, inside rocks, and deep beneath the surface.
Meanwhile, NASA's Mars missions keep looking for biosignatures of current and past life. Until recently, things seemed to be going according to plan, but one event turned everything upside down. In early 2021, NASA sent the Mars rover Perseverance to the Red Planet. It was accompanied by the Ingenuity helicopter, which performed 72 flights over the Martian surface within 3 years. Perseverance, on the other hand, is about the size of a car and is equipped with 7 scientific instruments, one of which is the radar imager for Mars subsurface exploration, RIMFAX. Perseverance makes the discovery that the Jezero crater on Mars was at one point full of water, offering the tantalizing hope that it may have already discovered fossilized organisms on the planet. Shortly after this discovery, the mission's timetable goes totally wrong. Since arriving on Mars, the rover has been searching for signs of ancient life, collecting dozens of rock samples for eventual shipment back to Earth. To return its precious cargo, the rover must await the arrival of a planetary lander equipped with a small rocket, which the rover will load with its rock and soil samples. It will then be launched back into orbit. Once launched into space, the rocket will be captured by an orbiter that will return it to Earth. NASA originally planned for this to happen sometime in 2026, but then the date was pushed back to 2028, meaning the samples would return to Earth in 2033 at the earliest. However, it now appears that this may never actually happen. In a review of the plan, experts point out that it had unrealistic budget and schedule expectations from the start. This effectively allows for abuse on a grand scale. As a result, the budget committee concluded, there is currently no credible, consistent technical, nor properly delineated schedule, cost, and technical baseline that can be met with the likely funding available. Studying the virgin material from the Red Planet in well-equipped laboratories around the world could have provided key insights into Mars, including whether there was once life there. NASA, for its part, says it will look for a new, cheaper, and faster way to transport the valuable samples from Mars to Earth. After the meeting, Nikki Fox, Deputy Administrator of NASA's Science Mission Directorate, said,
"To wait this long, this is unacceptable. We should have astronauts landing on Mars by the 2040."
The wheels of the new plan seem to be turning in full force today. Haka has turned to the Southern California Laboratory for peak-tiv propulsion and to other agency outreach centers for new ideas. In addition, the agency is also reaching out to private industry, providing a platform for the presentation of new ideas from the industry. As you can see, the official information on what NASA is looking for on Mars is just so contradictory and incomprehensible. So imagine if we dig into other countries' research or conspiracy theories. But if you want us to do it, leave us a comment. But while we wonder what's happening on Mars, there are equally mysterious and unexplored territories on our planet. If you didn't know that, then now is the time to watch our video about Antarctica and the recent discoveries made there, which frankly amazed us too. Click the video on your screen now, and we'll be together again in a second.